All right, so now that we know where all our members are going to go on our oblique ended hip roof, now we have to work out what bevels we need to cut them. So in this video I'm going to show you how to develop the bevels geometrically so you can work out all the angles that you need. Now with this particular oblique ended roof, we're going to need 15 bevels. Essentially they're the same bevels as we do for a normal hip roof, except because we've got two different length hips, that means we're going to have different plumb level and edge bevels for each hip, and we also have an extra edge bevel on our crowned rafter, so we actually end up with 15 bevels for this roof. Anyway, so to start, first thing you need to do is make sure that you use the correct rise for your roof, or you use the correct angle. Span's not going to matter as long as we're using the correct rise for your roof. So 30 degrees, 25, whatever your angle is, make sure that that's right. And obviously that is going to create our first bevel, which is our plumb bevel for our common rafter, and our second bevel, which is our level bevel for our common rafter. So they're the first two easy ones. The next one we want to do is our edge bevel for our hips. So because we've got two different hips, we're actually going to have two separate edge bevels. So this is the long hip, this is the short hip. So what we do is anywhere along here, we draw in a creeper. 90 degrees to the plate, doesn't matter where it sits, doesn't have to be at any particular centers, anywhere along there, 90 degrees to the plate, draw in a creeper till it hits the plan length of our hip. Now where it meets the hip, we then develop that up, and that would give us now, that gives us the true length of our creeper, in this case. Okay, so we've drawn that in, develop that up. Then we take this distance from here to the corner and we transfer that distance up here at 90 degrees to the true length of our hip, or true length of our creeper, sorry, true length of our creeper. 90 degrees, that length there is equal to that length there, and join that back to that point there, and that will give us our third angle, which is our edge bevel for our creeper going into our long hip. Now we need to do the same on the other side, so we repeat the process. Draw in a creeper, develop that up, measure this distance, draw it in at 90 degrees to our true length, join up the two points. And that'll give us our edge bevel for our short hip. So there's our two edge bevel creepers for our short, for our hips. All right. So now we want to go down and do our hip bevels. So I'll get rid of all this development work. Go down and have a closer look at our hips. So I'm going to work on the long hip first. So the first thing we need to do is we're going to come up the rise. So remember the rise distance here. Transfer that down onto our hip at 90 degrees. And then we join up the two points. So that gives us the true length of our hip here. So then that gives us our plumb bevel for our hip, for our long hip, and our level bevel for our long hip. Pretty easy. We then need the edge bevel for the hip. So what we do, come off the plan length of the hip at 90 degrees. Doesn't matter where you draw this line, as long as it runs into the crown end rafter somewhere. So you could draw it up here, but I'm trying to keep it as long as possible because the bigger my angles, or the bigger my development, the more accurate my angles will be. So I've made that as long as possible, 90 degrees to the plan length of the hip. I then just develop that line straight through, and where that hits the true length of the hip, we then come off there at 90 degrees, this length, whatever length that happened to be, come off the same distance. Then we join this back to this apex or this point here. And that'll give us bevel 7, which is the edge bevel for our long hip. So, of course, again, we've got two hips and then need to repeat the process on the other side. So, short hip, 90 degrees, come up our rise, join those two points. That'll give us our plumb bevel and our level bevel for the short hip. Again, to do the edge bevel, come off the plan length at 90 degrees. Once again, could be anywhere along here as long as it hits the crown end rafter. I've chosen to keep it as long as possible. Fill up that line up till it meets the true length. Take this distance, 90 degrees, and join that back to there. And that will give you the edge bevel for the short hip. So as you can see, we're already at 10 bevels and we've only just got the hips done. Right, the next one we need to do is the edge bevel for the crown end rafter. So what we do, anywhere along the crown end rafter, we come off at 90 degrees, as I've done here, and we need to run the line so it hits the crown, sorry, the centering rafter. Again, I've kept mine as long as possible just to make the development as big as possible. So 90 degrees till it hits the centering rafter. We then have to take this distance here and transfer that around and up onto our true length here. And then we take this distance, that original line that we developed, and come off from this point 90 degrees, the same distance, and then we join that back down to the apex, and that will give us bevel 11, which is the edge bevel for the crown end rafter. Everything else on the crown end rafter will be the same. We'll use the plumb bevel and the level bevel for the common rafter. We just needed that edge bevel. Okay, and now we need to do our purlin bevels. So, what we do for our purlin bevels? 90 degrees to our true length here. We come off and we make sure that that line intersects at the center of the bottom of our elevation. So, down there like that. And it's 90 degrees because that's the angle that the purlin's going to sit to the rafter. We then develop this length. Develop that around till it hits there, and we then transfer those two points, so that point there and this point here, transfer down until they hit the long hip in this case. Now, where this one hits the long hip, we then come off at 90 degrees to that line. All right, and then from this point here, we draw a line back to our intersection in the middle, like that. And that will give us the face bevel for our purlin for the long hip side of the roof. So face bevel purlin for the long hip. We then need the edge bevel for the purlin. And we've already worked that out. It's actually the opposite to our edge bevel common rafter. So sorry, edge bevel creeper to the long hip. So we've already got bevel 13 there. Obviously, we need to do the same on the other side of the roof for the short hip. So drawing in this line here, 90 degrees to our true length, making sure it meets at the intersection here in the middle of the elevation. Transfer that distance around to the bottom of the elevation. Transfer those two dimensions down till they hit the short hip. Right. Where this one hits the short hip here, we come 90 degrees across, and then from this point back to our apex, and that will give us our face bevel for our purlin for our short hip. And then for our edge bevel for our short hip, as before, we've already developed it. It is the opposite to our edge bevel creeper for the short hip. So it's there. That's bevel 15. So that's all our bevels developed, and that's what it should look like. So once you've done that, you can then transfer your bevels onto whatever you like and start cutting your riff members.